Good morning dear students, welcome once again. So today we will start a new chapter, that is heat transfer or transmission of heat. Now since junior classes you all have learned and know that if two bodies of different temperatures, it means a hot body and a cold body, if they are placed or kept in contact with each other, then heat always flows from hot body to cold body. Means the direction of flow of heat is always from the body at a high temperature to the body at a lower temperature. Since flow is always from high potential to low potential, it is also applicable in case of water flow of water also. Now this is the case of the two bodies at different temperatures. Now if there is a temperature difference between the two parts or the different parts of a single body, same body, then heat also transfers from hot region to cold region. For example, if we take any metal rod, maybe iron rod or copper rod, aluminium rod, anything else, okay. Now if we heat at its one end, then obviously the end which we will heat will be at high temperature, and the other part which will be at the far end from the source of heat will be at a low temperature, that is the cold region. So in this case it also flows from the hot region, it is hot end to cold end. It is happening in case of a single body. So this process of transmission of heat from hot region to cold region is called heat transfer. Clear? Very simple. Now since in this world everything has a definite process and every phenomenon or process follows some rules, everything follows some process, so heat transfer also takes place through some processes. Okay, since we all know that the matter exists in three states, that is solid, liquid and gas, so the question is, does heat transfer take place through all these state of matters by same process? The answer is no. A heat transfer takes place in three processes: conduction, convection and radiation. So now one by one we will try to understand these processes. The first one is conduction. Clear? Now generally inside solid heat is transferred through this process. Clear? Any solid. Okay, now you can see inside the word conduction there is a word conductor, and you all are very much acquainted with the word conductor, isn't it? That is which helps in conduction of electricity. Okay, so here we will only discuss about the heat transfer. Okay, so in our daily experiences we all know that whenever we heat anything, isn't it, and tea or coffee by using a saucepan or anything, okay, now if we heat anything by holding one end of any metal, okay, now very quickly the other end, isn't it, the other end, generally the end which we hold, becomes heated very quickly, isn't it? Okay, now what is the reason behind it? Because conduction is responsible for this process. Okay, what is the explanation? What is conduction? The conduction is the process in which heat transfers from high temperature to low temperature, that is hot region to cold region, without leaving the position or the place of the molecules. It means the process in which molecule doesn't change their position and heat transfer from hot body to cold body. I think it is clear to you, isn't it? It means the process of heat transfer in which molecules doesn't leave their places, without leaving or without changing their position, they remain standstill in their position. They don't leave their places, the molecules as well as the free electrons, but in spite of that heat is transferred from hot body to cold body. So the process in which heat is transferred from hot body to cold body but molecules do not leave the places or position is called conduction. Inside solid, in this process heat is transferred inside solid. Clear? Now we would like to understand this process through a very simple example. You can see the diagram, isn't it? Now suppose the construction of a building is going on. We will try and we will explain the three processes through same example, but in quite different manner. Suppose the construction of a building is going on. Okay. So obviously in that group there will be a head mason, who is the head, who is the boss, and others are laborers, which are his helper. So suppose the head mason is asking for a brick means give me a break. Okay. Now you can see all the levers. Here I have shown only, okay, only 3 levers. So suppose there are 10 or 15 levers. Okay. 7, 8. Okay. Maximum 10. So head mason is busy in his work and he is commanding. Okay. He is ordered for a break. Please give me one break. Now you can see how the levers are standing. They are standing very adjust, very close, very densely packed. Isn't it? Just which happens exactly in case of solids. Because in solids we know that the molecules are densely packed, very closely packed. So what happens when we heat? When the solid is heated, at first the molecules very close to the source of the heat at first agitated. It means they start vibrating, their kinetic energy increases. And this kinetic energy from that, from those molecules of the region are generally transmitted to the next molecules. And they start to vibrate. Again, their energy, they transfer the energy or vibe through their vibration to the next molecule, then next molecule, then next molecule, and so on. And in these processes, the region which was first agitated by supplying its kinetic energy to the next molecule, they become cool. The kinetic energy decreases because they transfer kinetic energy through vibration to the next layers, molecules. Then from next to next, next. In this process, what happens? The previous region becomes colder. Why? Because always the previous layer transfers heat to the next region and then next, next. So previous layer is just, what can I say? They are just reducing, okay. They are just reducing their kinetic energy, losing kinetic energy, and the next molecules and the molecules of the next region are acquiring those energy. So the previous layers have become colder and the next layers have become hotter. So in this process, heat is transferred in the solid. So what was the example? Since here the levers, here the levers are the closely densed molecules. Okay. Now when the head mason was asking for the break, they thought a plan. Then why will you just change our position? Okay. We will just hand over, isn't it? He said, give me a break. Then first lever takes the break. Then he handed over the break to the next one. Then to next. Then to next. And finally, who is very close to the head mason, he transfers, he gives the mason that break. Isn't it? So it means in this case, the levers don't need to leave their own position or, isn't it, of that place. But the break is already reached up to the head mason. So this is the conduction process. It means the molecules don't leave or change their position, but it is transferred. So this is conduction. Clear? Generally inside solid, all kind of solids conduction process is generally takes place. Moves on to convection. Okay. Convection is the process in which heat is transferred, unlike conduction. When heat is always transferred from hot body to cold body. But in this process, molecules as well as free electrons, okay, change their position. Okay, they shift their position and heat is transferred to from hot body to cold body. It generally takes place inside liquid and gas. Only liquid and gas. Convection never takes place inside conduction in case of solids. Okay, convection is the process of heat transfer through convection only takes place in liquid and gas. Clear? Now we may have seen solids are generally in generally metals. Metals are generally becomes heated very quickly, very rapidly in comparison to liquid and gas. Why? Because in this case, in case of conduction, molecules as well as free electrons, both takes place simultaneously. Isn't it? They generally contribute simultaneously. In this case, the free electrons, we know that the conductors has a huge, isn't it? A huge number of free electrons inside conductors, okay, which are free to move. Okay, which are free to move, random, which moves randomly. So generally free electrons are responsible for taking for conduction of electricity inside solid. But here the molecules, we may assume the free electrons, we may assume behaves as the molecules. So since molecules are the free electrons, okay, large number of electrons, so that's why in case of solids, I'm talking about metals, there are so many solids, wood, plastic, these are called bad conductors. It depends on conductivity, which we will discuss later in the next video. So generally in case of conductors, good conductors, that is metals, iron, copper, aluminium, silver, all these. In these cases, they are becomes heated very quickly because since they have a large number of free electrons along with the molecules, so they can transfer heat at a speed of light. It takes place at a almost as a very high rate, very quickly. So that's why conductors get heated very quickly. Whereas in case of convection, liquid and gas, they have few, they have less number of free electrons. They have also molecules, but since they have lack, they suffer from lack, they have less number of free electrons as compared to solids. So that's why liquid and gas generally get heated then slowly, comparatively slowly as compared to solid. Now what is the logic behind it? We have already discussed and already explained the conduction process. In convection, what happens, as I already said, molecules himself, molecules as well as the less number of electrons change their position. They have to change their position to transfer the heat. What happens now when we heat, when we pour some liquid, that is milk or water or tea on any vessel, and when we heat it through burner, so the lower portion of the liquid molecules at first become agitated and they expand in volume. So since after expansion of volume, it becomes lighter, so it moves up in the upper region, and the upper region and the molecules of the upper region, which is at a cold, at low temperature, since they are cold, so the density is more, they takes their places. So then explosion is the same. Explosion is the same. At first, the molecules which are very close to the Bunsen burner, which are heated, they are become first agitated by acquiring kinetic energy. But this process is a slow process. It takes place more slowly as compared to solids because of less number of free electrons. They have large number of free electrons, which has a major contribution. Large number of free electrons, they will do the work very rapidly. More number of levers, large number of levers will do the work, will take and finish the work at a very short period of time. Since less number of electrons, so it will take time to complete the task. Less number of workers, we may assume like this. Okay, so the next molecule, at first the molecules very close to the source of the heat becomes very agitated or heated, acquiring kinetic energy through vibration. Then they will transfer their kinetic energy to the next region, then next, then next. Then this, the process is the same. Transferring the kinetic energy, isn't it? Or vibration, thermal energy to the next molecules, molecules of the next layer. Same process is generally happening. But in this case, due to less number of free electrons, this process express slightly, it's a slow process. Slow process is also, if we heat, the conduction takes place in case of wood, isn't it? Wood or plastic, these are all solids. In those cases, conduction also takes place very slowly. It also happens fast only in case of metals. So now, in these cases, what happened and what is the difference between us? In those cases, molecules, the free electrons, don't need to leave their places, but here they change their places. Now, same example, but they're slightly changed. Now, suppose head pressure is present in a particular day, suppose a very hot day or a very rainy season, or there may be some problem of the other levers in their home, in the house. So, suppose there is only one, there is only one lever is present on a particular day and the head pressure. And again, he was asking for the break. Then there is nobody, there is no other levers, so that he can hand over the brake. So what he had to do, so what he will have to do, he will have to take the brake and he will have to walk himself and to give the brake to the head mason. So actually it happens in case of convection, when the molecules itself as well as the less free electrons itself work or change their position and transfer heat from hot region to cold region, and this is called convection. Clear? Now, the third process is radiation. Now, the three processes, the two processes, since they are transferring heat from one place to another through walking and through handing over. So it clearly means that for heat transfer both in conduction and convection, a medium is required. Very clear. Since they are handing over the bricks and he is working, so obviously in medium must, the presence of a medium is mandatory in both these cases. But in radiation, what happens in this process? Heat is transferred from one place to another, from hot body to cold body, without any presence of any molecules. Don't need, since without any presence of any medium. It generally transfers in the forms of electromagnetic wave. In the forms of electromagnetic wave, this is the process in which the heat from the sun reaches to earth. Clear? Since it transfers in the form of the electromagnetic waves, so it doesn't need any medium. So since it doesn't need any medium, so there is no question of of the shifting or not shifting of the molecules of their positions. Now what is the explanation here? Here expression is, you can clearly see. Now the head mason was still asking for a break. Now suddenly, suppose a thorn, isn't it? Something has a sting inside its feet. Or what happened? Somehow he could not walk. Something has happened to his leg or any problem due to which he cannot walk. So what will happen? And he is very close to him. So now how he could reach? How the brick could be reached up to the head mason? Throwing. He don't need to hand over the brick to the next levers. He don't need to work, or it means he doesn't need to change his position or location. Just throwing, and the heat and the brick is just reached up to the head mason. It means there is no need of the position to change a position or not to change the position. Doesn't matter. Only throwing and the brick is reached. He has thrown the brick and reached. And the head mason got the brick. Is the only the matter of, isn't it, the achieving, obtaining, getting the brick anyhow, through handover, through walking and through throwing. So it doesn't need any, in this case doesn't need any medium. Clear? This is radiation. So since it doesn't need any medium, so it doesn't heat that medium. If any medium is present whatsoever, it doesn't need that particular medium. Clear? So this is radiation. If you remember this logic, this example, the process of heat transfer becomes very easy. So how can you differentiate? What are the differences between these three processes? You can see, that is, at first, the definition. That is, when heat transfers from hot body to cold body without shifting the position of the molecules, here the change of the position of the molecules is required. There is no need to change any position molecules. Number two, in this case, conduction takes place only in solids, convection takes place in liquid and gas, whereas radiation takes place in the form of electromagnetic wave. Heat reaches from sun to earth. Next is, these two processes are slow processes, maybe slow process, but this is a rapid process. This takes place, since it takes place in the form of electromagnetic wave, whose velocity is very close to velocity of light, 3 into 10 to the 12 meter per second. So it's a very fast, rapid process in comparison to two. Next is, in these two processes, conduction and convection may take place in straight path or in crooked way or in bent path, that is zigzag path. There is no mandatory rule. But in case of radiation, it always takes place in straight line, since electromagnetic wave, light, in case of rectilinear propagation of light, it always takes place in straight line. Isn't it? That's why we need umbrella, to get rid of from the heat of the sun. Isn't it? Next process, these two processes needs a medium. This doesn't need any medium. Next, these two processes, since in case for transferring of heat, in these two processes, conduction and convection, a medium is required. So obviously, in case of transmission of heat, these two processes heats the medium. The medium is heated by these two processes. Whereas in case of radiation, the medium doesn't heat it. Because medium is not required, since it only transfers through vacuum, that is free space in absence of air. So this is conduction, convection and radiation.